In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your e-gift card from beginning to end. I'm going to show you how to set up your product page. I'm going to show you how to issue gift cards should you want to issue gift cards without someone purchasing it. I'm going to show you how you can manage all of the gift cards once you start selling them. And I'm going to also show you how to customize the emails that are automatically sent out from Shopify to your customers, whether they're buying it or they're sending it as a gift. Hola, my name is Betsy from Betsy Lugo Creative, and I am a Shopify website designer here teaching you all of my tips, tricks, and resources so that you can build a Shopify store that you are proud of. Now let's jump in. I have a lot to show you.
Okay, so we are in our dashboard as always, and we're going to go to products, and then we're going to go to gift cards. Okay, so if you've never set one up before, this is exactly what it's going to look like. So we're going to add gift card product. So that's what we're going to go do first, and then we'll come back and create a gift card. So let's go ahead and start this. And it's just like creating any other product. So we're going to name it exactly what the name of the store, right? And then the only thing I'm going to add is actually I'm going to add E for electronic gift card, so there's no confusion about what this gift card is, okay? Then here, just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to just enter this information here. So this is their description here. And then what we want to do is, because it is an e-gift card and nothing is going to be mailed, we want to ensure that they see this, that it's very clear that they're not going to receive anything in the mail. Actually, let's go ahead and just take that out from there. All right, there we go. So that will be the description here. And then the media, again, just like your product description, you're going to go ahead and upload the image of your gift card. And you can create these mockups in Canva or in Placeit. I love them, use them all the time. I will leave the link for Placeit in the description down below. And then for the denominations, you want to make sure that the denominations match the pricing in your store. So if the least expensive item in the store is $25, so we're going to begin at the $25, and then we can go ahead and increase these to what makes more sense for this specific store. But you make those prices based on your pricing in your store. Okay, so we're going to keep it there. And then the search engine. So this is how your gift card is going to appear if it comes up in a search engine. So if somebody's looking for something, some gift cards, this is how it's going to show up. So what we can do here is 70 characters. So this is perfect. This is 320. I would suggest to keep this under 150. That way it doesn't get cut off like it is here based on the search engine in which your customers may be using. So let's shorten this up. That would be great. Unleash the power of self-expression with Fcking Shine gift card. Dive into a world where being yourself is celebrated without apologies. I love that. That's perfect. Just like that. And then also the URL handle, you can also change this up. So you can like delete the E there, so it's nice and short. I'm going to leave it in there because this client might actually implement physical gift cards. And so we want the URLs to be different. We don't want two URLs to be exactly the same for two different products. Okay, so just be mindful of that. So we're going to go ahead and leave it there, but know that you can change this should you wish to. All right, then we're going to come up here and we're going to go ahead and leave it in active. That's perfect there. The gift card is already attached for the product here. The vendor is the shop itself. We're going to go ahead and just put gift card here. And then here we're going to tag it as a gift card. Now you can add this to a collection should you want to. This store has a small inventory, so it's not needed, but you can add a tag. Just like if you have a gift category, you can add it to that category or any other category you wish to add it to. Now, as far as templates, I'm going to go ahead and add this to the default template. I've custom made a template for the t-shirts, but we're going to go ahead and leave this in the default template here. And then the gift card is already assigned. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and save this. Beautiful. And then we're going to go ahead and view it in the store and see what it would look like. All right, awesome. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change up the template here so that it shows if this is a gift where it's going to be sent to and add a note. So let's go ahead and do that next. So let's head over to the online store. We're going to customize and we're going to head over to your products. So we're going to go ahead and do the default product. I already had created a custom template for the products that are t-shirts. So for the gift card, I'm actually going to set it up for the default product. So this template is going to be for the gift card. As you can see here, the preview is the gift card right here. And so what I'm going to do is going to come over to where it says button, and we're going to select here where it says show recipient information form. And here we go. If you saw that pop up right here, I want to send this as a gift. Okay. And now because this is a gift card, for this particular template, I do not need this. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this. And then I believe that is all that we really need to remove from this product description. So let's go ahead and save that. All right, let's go back to this page and let's go ahead and refresh. And there we go. So now we have the gift card here and there's no need for the sizing chart because this is a gift card, correct? So now when the customer clicks on here to purchase it, they'll be able to not only select the gift card amount, but then they'll click on here and then they'll be able to add the recipient's name, email, and a message should they want to. And then you can also schedule to have that sent out. So that is pretty cool. And then they go ahead and finish up and the customer would just add it to the cart. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, so now let's head on back and let's go back to gift cards. And this time we're going to create a gift card that you want to give to a customer. So in this situation, you will create a gift card right here. And so what you will add here on this code, you can either leave it just like this, or you can customize this code. You could probably say something to the effect of thank you, and this is going to be a $10 gift card, so we can do thank you 10, right? The value of the card is going to be $10. Then the next part is the expiration date, so you can set it so it has no expiration date, or if you like to add an expiration date, just as it states right here, depending on where you will be issuing a gift cards to or gift certificates to, please ensure that you know the rules for that country or area where you're selling them to, because there are areas, especially here in the US, where you cannot sell gift cards that have an expiration date, okay? So just make sure that you're on top of this type of stuff. And then here for your customer, you can actually add your customers here. So I'm going to go ahead and add myself. All right, so that's saved. So now I am the customer right there, so it'll send it to me. And then internal notes here. So this is a gift card that you will be issuing. So this is for your internal purposes only. So you can put things in here. Like, for example, if you're running a giveaway, you can put in here, give a giveaway winner. If you are doing influencer marketing and you want to issue someone who's promoting your product a gift card, then you can add that there. So again, it's just for internal purposes only. Okay, then we're going to go ahead and save that. And then once you get to here, you have two options. We can either send the gift card via email, or you can copy and paste the code right here and then send it in a text or an email or however you want to send it to the person who's going to be receiving it. Okay, so you have both of those options, or you can do both. So I'm going to go ahead and send that gift card, and I'm going to show you what the email is going to look like. I'm going to also show you how to customize this so they don't get this generic gift card here. Okay, but this is what the notification will look like. So I'm going to go ahead and send that email, and I'm going to go ahead and retrieve it in just a moment here. So that is how you manually create a gift card. Okay, so here is my email for my gift card. They can either click right here and visit the store. They can also click right here and see the gift card balance. So here we go. They'll get this information right here. Okay, so what they can do is that they can just copy and paste this code here. Let's go to the store and let's go ahead and shop for something. Let's go ahead and click this. Let's throw this in the basket and let's check out. Okay, and then here is the discount code that's right here. So I will go ahead and enter that discount code here, click apply, and there we go. It is working perfectly. Now, when you're first starting, if you don't see this in your checkout when you try to test the code, sometimes the gift card doesn't appear if there is no gift card that has been issued or discount code that has been set up. So you would have to actually go ahead and create one just like I did now as a test so that this box comes up, because if it doesn't detect any discount codes or any gift cards that have been issued, this box will not show up. Just an FYI. Okay, so now let's head over back to the gift card here because I want to show you now what you have access to. So now when you click on gift card, you'll have this gift cards panel here. It will show you all of the gift cards that have been purchased and all of the gift cards that have been created. So the ones you've made, the ones people have bought, they will all be right here. And you're able to see what's been redeemed, whether they have a full card, it's partial, it's empty. So you have access to all of this information, which becomes really useful. So let me just click right here, right? So you can come here and you can see when it was purchased, when it was redeemed, all of that information, right? Now, the useful part about this is that, let's say someone has purchased a gift card and the recipient deleted it, not knowing, forgot, or whatever the case may be, you can come in here and see that the card hasn't been used. What you can do is you can go ahead and deactivate it and then reissue another gift card, or you can just simply copy the gift card code and then resend it to them so that they can use it. So this is where all your gift card information is going to be. Okay, we're almost at the home stretch. So now let's update the images that your customers see in their emails. So for this, the first step you have to do is update the image that you want to use in the email. So if you want, so we're going to go to content, files. Here, as you see, is the product image. So I'm going to go ahead and upload that. Perfect. So it's uploading now and we'll take a look at it. So we just created an image simply just for the email. So it's just one image of the gift card. So this is what we're going to add. Here is the size just for reference. It's 950 by 550. I selected this size because that is the size that is recommended by Shopify. All right, perfect. So now that this image is uploaded, you're gonna head over here where it says link. You're going to copy this link. Then we're gonna go to settings. So let's go over the gift card settings and then we'll move on to our notifications. So let's go to settings here for your gift cards. And so you have three settings here, which some of them we already went over. So here you can always set it so that gift cards never expire. So you can do it from right here. And if you ever have to change it, as we already saw on the other screen, you can make it expire if you want to. But this is kind of just overall settings for your gift cards. You can pre-select if you automatically want to send the gift card now. So you can set that here. And also, if you want to offer Apple Wallet passes, then you can activate this part here as well. All right, so let's close this and let's move on to our notifications here and then customer notifications. Okay. We're going to head down to where it says gift cards. So we have two emails that are sent out to your customers. The first one is the new gift card and then the gift card receipt. Okay, so there's two emails that go out. So let's change the first one. So this is a template. It shows you in the notifications what email looks like that they're going to send to your customers. So this is what it is. This is the generic gift card image that we're going to change. So we're going to head up here where it says edit code. And then we're going to come down to a section where it says the image source. Okay, so now this one, you do have to be careful because there's two image sources. In this file, I am using the Dawn theme, but here is the first one, line 102 for me. That's not the one we're going to change. We're going to actually head down this one further down. Let's look for that here. It's right here, image source. So it's this one. For me, it's line 194. Okay, so this is the one that we are going to change. So we're going to head in right in here, and we're going to paste the link copy. And then we're going to put this in quotations. So a quotation in the beginning and a quotation at the end, right? You're going to click save. Let's come up to here and let's preview it. And voila, there you go. So this is the email that they get when they purchase the gift card. So now let's do the same thing. We're going to head back. And we're going to head to the gift card and we're going to do the same thing. So we're going to click edit code. And we're going to come down to the image source. So here it is, line 92. So we're going to, same thing, we're going to highlight this area here, paste the link code, save, and let's preview it. And voila, there you go. Now, sometimes depending on the image size, I showed you what the image size was, but you see how this one looks a little bit stretched. What you can do is come right over here where it says width and height. So I'm going to go ahead and change that to 150. So I'm going to save that and let's preview this again. All right, beautiful. That looks much better. Let's go ahead and send the test so we can see what this looks like. And voila, this is what the email will look like. And then once this recipient sees this, so we did a sample one. So it's Bobby. Happy birthday. So once they receive this, and then they can click on here, go to the store, and they can also view their gift card balance here as well. So if they click on here, it'll take them to this page here where they can copy the gift code, which they will then use in the checkout.
That was a lot of information. I hope that you found this video valuable. Give me a thumbs up and please consider subscribing. Until next time, my friend, adios.